Hammerstead. I am Captain of the Ballbarker. This year was one of the longest, most dangerous campaigns that we have done to date. Not only did we face some of the roughest weather we've ever faced,
that weather resulted in us losing our scout vessel, the Bridget Bardot, very early on in the campaign. But we also faced an increasingly aggressive adversary, one that has shown as little regard for human life as cetacean life. And they showed that when they injured several crew members on board the Steve Irwin. I think what we saw this year was an increasingly desperate Japanese whaling industry. They showed as little regard for human life as they did for the laws of Australia. And what we saw this year was that the Japanese whaling fleet continuously entered the economic waters of Australia, the territorial sea limit of Australia. And it's one of the reasons it's so good to be back in Hobart is it was just a few months ago that off Macquarie Island, we witnessed the harpoon vessel Yushin Maru No. 3 come as close as 4 nautical miles off the shore of Macquarie Island. Macquarie Island is a World Heritage Site. It's also under the governance of Tasmania. And it was thanks to the support and the determination of Senator Bob Brown and the Australian Greens that these killers were finally driven off the shores of Australia. Last year we bankrupted the Japanese whaling fleet. This year we once again succeeded in sinking them economically. And the Japanese whaling industry just recently released that they killed 267 whales this season. That means that Sea Shepherd prevented the Japanese whaling industry from taking 75% of the quota. That's 768 whales saved, and that's a tremendous victory to us. Although this was one of the most dangerous campaigns we've faced, we are absolutely 100% committed to continuing to intervene against the Japanese whaling fleet until peace is finally restored to the Southern Ocean Whale Sanctuary. For us, the word sanctuary actually means something. So no matter what the danger that we face, we are 100% committed to returning to the Southern Ocean. If the Japanese whaling fleet decides to return at the end of this year, we will return stronger, we'll return more effective than ever. I wouldn't be surprised if the Japanese whaling fleet stepped up their aggression towards us next year, but we are completely undeterred. For us, we need to enforce these laws. Nobody's enforcing the law against these whalers. When we found the Nishin Maru, the factory whaling ship of the Japanese fleet, we found them 65 nautical miles north of the Australian coastline. That's firmly within the Southern Ocean Whale Sanctuary, it's firmly within the Australian Antarctic Territory, and it's firmly within the Australian Economic Exclusion Zone. Nobody's enforcing the law against these guys, and if nobody will, then we'll take that upon ourselves. I think the reason that the Japanese whaling fleet called their season short this year is that they didn't want further confrontation with us. Once we found the Japanese factory whaling ship off the coast of Antarctica, we basically sealed the deal for them. Morale's been up and down. It's been hard being dogged continuously by Japanese security ships. This year, Japan allocated a $30 million security budget to the Japanese whaling fleet specifically to stop Sea Shepherd. This was money that was diverted from tsunami relief efforts. But despite all of this, despite the odds set against us, we were able to once again send the Japanese whaling fleet home early. We were able to save 768 whales from slaughter, and we've come out victorious.